मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव डे 6 फॉर ऑनलाइन मैथमेटिक्स क्लास ऑन चैप्टर 1 दैट इज रियल नंबर। लास्ट क्लास आई डिस्कस्ड सम क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द एक्सरसाइज 1.1 ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक। आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग द सेम एक्सरसाइज एंड द फर्दर एक्सरसाइज the solutions of some problems. All the students are supposed to learn very carefully, sincerely, and you can discuss anything if you find any problems, any doubts in the explanation or in the solution of the problems I am explaining. Now I am going to discuss question number 3 from your textbook of NCERT, that is here, an army contingent of 616 members is to march behind an army band 32 members in a parade. The two groups are to march in the same number of columns. What is the maximum number of column in which they can march? So first of all, we will see number of army contingent members, that is given 616. But another thing is given to you here is member to march behind an army band of 32 members. So army band members 32. So exactly from this sentence, this problem, what we understand, what to find, only two things we discuss particularly in this chapter, that is highest common factor and the lowest common multiple. So what we are going to discuss, first we need to know that. So from this statement, as you observe here, that 616 member is to march behind an army band of 32 members. Army band will be 32. Behind that, contingent will be standing. So how many contingent will be coming behind the army band? So as equally in size, the number of army band should come in the form of a square. How many members will come in a row or in a column? That we have to find exactly. So what we find from here? Exactly, I am telling, we are going to discuss here about highest common factor. Highest common factor of these two integers. So let us consider here A equal to 616 and B, that is 32. So here B will be considered as divisor. We have from Euclid's lemma for positive integers a, b, q and r, that a equal to b q plus r, where r is less than b and greater than r equal to 0. So step 1 comes here. So we divide 616 by 32. So first we can divide it one time. 32, subtract 32 from here, so we will get here 29. Again carrying down 6, after that we will see how many times we can divide it. If we see 9 times, 9 to the 18, 9 to 27 or 128. 288. Subtract this, the remainder will be 8. Now we cannot divide further because this quotient will be coming in decimal presentation, but we need always the value of quotient and remainder in the form of positive integers. So here is a equal to b cube plus r. A is taken here 616, b is taken as divisor 32, into quotient is coming 19, remainder is coming 8, where r is not equal to 0. Thereafter we proceed it. After this we go for the next step 2. Here we will consider the current divisor will be considered as dividend, remainder will be considered as divisor, and then we will see how many times we can divide this. 4 times, 32, subtract this minus, then remainder is coming 0. So we get here q equal to 4 and remainder r equal to 0, and therefore we can write here 32 is equal to, according to this concept, a equal to bq plus r. A is 32 and b is 8, quotient q is 4 and remainder r is 0. So here we write r equal to 0. So whenever we get remainder r equal to 0, what we can say here, the highest common factor of these two positive integers given will be the recent divisor, that is 8. So we can say here HCF of 616 and 32 is same as the HCF of 32 and 8, and that is equal to 8. So in the last we can conclude here, and therefore we find there should be eight members behind the army band. So when we get here highest common factor of the given two integers, we find the number of members which are standing behind the army band in equal number of rows and columns, that is equal to 8, that is HCF of 616 and 32. Is that clear? Okay, whenever anything, any problem will be coming, you are supposed to ask in your comment box or through your WhatsApp group, you can question your problems. Okay, alright, I am moving to the next question now. Question number 4. Come on students, for question number 4. We have to see this question. We are given to use here Euclid's division lemma to show that the square of any positive integer is either of the form of 3m or 3m plus 1 for some integer m. So let us consider a equal to 3m plus g, 3m equal to 3m plus 0, or a equal to 3m plus 1, which is in the form of a equal to bq plus r, where r is less than b but greater than r equal to 0. Thus we get here b equal to 3. B is the divisor, and therefore we can consider r equal to 0, 1, 2. We can consider r is equal to 0, 1 and 2 because we are given the value of r less than b and greater than r equal to 0. Now, when we observe here the value of, therefore, the positive integer, possible values of the positive integer may be a equal to 3 q plus 0 or 3 q plus 1 or 3 q plus 2. So these type of numbers it may be. So we can write here A equal to 3q, 3q plus 1 or 3q plus 2. Now we have to see square of any positive integer. So if A equal to 3q, then A square will be 3q square whole square, means 9q square, which we can write 3 into 3q square. So this can be written as 3 into m if m equal to 3q square is q is n integer. So we get here a square is coming as a multiple of 3. Check here. We have the possible values of the positive integers are 3q, 3q plus 1, 3q plus 2. But we are asked here the square of any positive integer. Whatever three numbers we have obtained here, 3q, 3q plus 1 and 3q plus 2, we have to find their squares. So one value is selected here. If a is 3q, so square of it comes 9q square. From this, we can have a common factor 3. Then we get a factor, product is 3q square. Since q is taken an integer, so q square will be integer. 3 is also integer. So 3 into q square become an integer. And this value is assumed as m. M is therefore said to be integer because 3q is integer. So m, its value is replaced by n under symbol. And then a is known as an integer, and therefore the value of a square is coming in the form of the multiple of 3. So first option which is given your problem, that is coming true. Let us consider another value of a. Suppose 3q plus 1, so that a square will be coming 9q square plus 6q plus 1. Here in this 3 times, from these two terms, we can take 3 common. So 3 into 3q square plus 2q, thereafter plus 1 is additional. So this value can be written as 3 into m plus 1 if m is equal to 3q square plus 2q. The multiple of 3 which is coming is considered as an integer m, and therefore we get here a square is changing in the form of 3m plus 1 when we consider m equal to 3q square plus 2q. So there is another pattern of the number which is given, 3m plus 1, that is satisfying here. Now one more number is left. If a is equal to 3q plus 2, let us see for this also. If a equal to 3q plus 2, so that a square means 9q square plus 12q plus 4. In this, we can write it 9q square plus 12q plus 3, and then plus 1 can be separated. From this bracket we can take common 3, so it will be 3q square plus 4q plus 1 plus 1, which we can write 3m plus 1 if m equal to 3q square plus 4q plus 1. So we are getting the pattern of the number which is asked in your problem, and hence a square is coming in the form of 3m plus 1. Thus the square of the positive integer occur in the form of 3m or 3m plus 1. So these are the results always when we square such a positive integer. So either it is changing in the form of the multiple of 3 or 1 more than the multiple of 3. Always you are looking 1 plus means we can say 1 more, and 3 means multiple of 3. So we can say the result of a square will be coming either directly any multiple of 3, or it will be coming 1 more than the multiple of 3. So we can check any such numbers you are getting, whatever the value of the form of the number is given, we are supposed to compare it from the Euclid's lemma statement, that is a equal to bq plus r. When we recognize the value of b, thereafter we can determine what possible values of remainder r will be there, and then we can write the value of the given positive integer or required positive integer, and after that, as per the instructions in your problem, it is given e square of such integers. So we are getting one by one, separate values are taken for a and they are e squared. After e squaring, we are getting it in the two patterns. First pattern, a multiple of 3. Second is coming one more than the multiple of 3. Is that clear? So there is one another question in your exercise, that is question number 5. Likewise, you are given some pattern of the number. You have to recognize their value of b, find out the possible values of the quotient device as remainder. After that, you can write all possible values of the positive integer. But in that question, you are given to find the cubes. But there will be lot number of values of a com. So for each and every one, you have to work out for the cubes of a given number, and then you will have to check whether it comes in the given pattern or not. Definitely you will be getting the results will be coming in the said pattern, given pattern in your problem, definitely. Is that clear? Thank you all. Come on students, now we are going to discuss about the prime factorization of any given composite number. Last time we had one theorem, fundamental theorem of arithmetic, in which I say every composite number can be expressed in the form of their prime factorization, and each and every prime factors are unique apart from the order in which they occur. That I said. Now we are going to look into the prime factorization of the given number. So let us see the prime factorization of 3825. This method was your earlier method. Now I will be, after this I will be explaining you in a different pattern how to get the prime factorization, how to write the prime factorization by using tree diagram, okay, by using the network. So first of that, we are doing our traditional method how to find their prime factorization. As we see, the unit digit of the number is 5. So we can work out the multiple, maybe 3 or multiple maybe 5. So when we see by 3, can we divide this by 3? We have to check. 3 plus 8, 11 plus 2, 13 plus 5, 18. So definitely we can divide this number by 3. So let us see here. 3 1 time, 3 2 times, 6 remainder 2, 3 7 is 21, then 1 is remaining, 3 5 is 15. Okay. Likewise, let us see the sum of all the digits here. 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 7, 10 plus 5, 15. Again, this can be divided by 3. So 3, 4 is 12, 3, 2 is 6, 3, 5 is 15. Again, add these digits. 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 5, 11. That is not divisible by 3, but the unit digit of the number is 5, so it can be divided by 5 only. So 5 is 40 and 5 5 is 25. Next, again the unit digit is 5, so it can be divided by 5. So 5 17 times, but 17 is already a prime number, so we cannot further divide, only 17 can divide it. This is the way how we factorize a given number using their prime factorization. But little bit the pattern here in this class, we have little change in that. First factor is 3. Write the factorization this. What quotient is coming? Write like this, this side. The number is left 1275. Another factor is again 3. Write it this side. What is remaining? 425. Write this 425 here. Next divisor, divisor is 5. Divisor will be written here. How many times this divides? 85 times. Write 85 here. Another divisor is 5. Divides it 17 times. That's all. So likewise, the other numbers we are written, prime numbers. These prime numbers being written all, actually they are the factors of the given number. And hence, we can write here 3825. That can be written as 3 into 3 into 5 into 5 into 17. Or that can be written as 3 square into 5 square into 17. Likewise, using the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, a composite number can be factorized into their prime factors. And in last, we can express the prime factors if repetitions are coming of any prime number. So we can write in the, that in the form of their exponential pattern. Alright? So likewise, whatever a number is given, composite number is given, you are supposed to find out the prime factorization. Instead of this pattern, better you apply this new pattern and write all the prime factors in right like way. In the last moment, you can express the prime factors in their form of exponential methods. Alright? So there are so many questions in your textbook, so you are supposed to work out with this. And thereafter, I will be continuing some another questions, how to find the LCM and HCF of two given positive integers using the method of prime factorizations. Okay, so let us wait for the next question that I am going to discuss from the same exercise. Okay. Dear students, let us see this question number 2, second part, where you have to find the LCM and HCF of two given positive integers 510 and 92. So first of all, we have to see the prime factorization of the given numbers. Let us have last unit digit is 0 there. So it is even, so we can divide it by 2 times. So what is remaining here? 255. 510 divided by 2, 255 times. But 257 and 512. 510 to 12, that number is divisible by 3. So another factor of this number will be 3. So let us see how many times it divides it. 3, 8 is 24, remainder 1, and 3, 5 is 15, 85 times. Thereafter, 8, 5, 13 cannot be divided by 3. But unit digit of this number is 5, so we can divide it by 5, and this divides 85 17 times, and 17 is itself a prime number, and therefore we can write 510 is equal to 2 into 3 into 5 into 17. These are the prime factors, and each prime factor is coming single time only. So leave it like that only. After that, I am working for 92. Another composite number which is even. So the first divisor of this number will be 2, and it can be divided by 46 times. This 4 plus 6, 10 cannot be divided by 3, only it can be divided by 2. So 2 divides these 23 times. But 23 is itself a prime number that further it cannot be divided, and therefore 92 can be written as 2 into 2 into 23 means 2 square into 23. Now, first we will see LCM of these two numbers 510 and 92, for which we have a formula that product of all prime factors with their highest exponent. So what are the prime factors? 2 is one prime factor, 3 is another prime factor, 5 is another prime factor, Thereafter, 17 is another prime factor. 23 is another prime factor. These are all the prime factors, but 2 is coming 2 times. So we can write it 2 is square. It means 4 into 3 into 5 into 17 into 23. When we multiply this all, we will get the LCM of 2 positive integers 510 and 92. So that will be 4, 3, 12, 12 into 5, 60, 60 into 17 into 23. 17 into 602, this is 1020, then into 23. So this will be 3060 and 2040. Means 0, 6, 4, 3, 2, 2, 3, 4, 6, 0, that is LCM of 510 and 92. This is LCM. After that, we'll go for HCF. HCF of same 510 and 92. Here we multiply only common prime factors. Common prime factors, here 2, here also 2 is a factor. In 92, 2 is factor, 510 also. 3, we don't have 3 a common. It is available only for one but not for the other. 5 is also not available in both. 17 is not also available in both. And 23 is not also available in both. So only a single common factor is here, that is 2. And in between these, we have to consider this with least exponent. Least exponent means in these two numbers, which number having the smaller exponent, here is 1, here is 2. We will consider 2 power 1 or only that can be written as 2. So HCF of these two numbers will be 2 only. But LCM will be 23,460. So you are supposed to see all the prime factorizations of the given numbers for both or any number of numbers are given. In that, you are supposed to check there what are the prime factors for LCM. You are supposed to multiply all possible prime factors we have got, and then we will multiply with their highest exponent. Multiplying all those numbers, you will get the LCM of these two numbers. But for HCF, we have to multiply only common prime factors with their least exponent. So in the common prime factor, we are getting only 2 is a common prime factor, and the least power of 2 is coming 1 here. So it means 2 is only the highest common factor of 510 and 92. Is it clear? Thank you all. You are supposed to repeat some questions from the exercise and tell me further. Whenever you get any doubt, in the comment box or in WhatsApp group, you can ask your doubts to me. Okay. Thank you all. Wish you all the best. Good luck.
Last time.